Hey guys, I have an application to build this week, and I'd like to invite you guys to come along and actually build this application with me. I'll show you all my tips and secrets as I go along. You'll see all the steps that I take while building an application. We'll create a new screen and a new SharePoint list that will hold all the users that will use this app. Then in the future, we'll build on this application. Sounds fun? Let's get going.
Whoa.
All right, so the first thing we need to do is tackle the users component. First thing you want to do is go over to your SharePoint site that we'll be using as a database. Now here at the SharePoint site, I'm going to go into site contents. I want to create a brand new SharePoint list. Go in blank list. I'm going to prefix all the tables with TBL. The reason why I do this is because when you're in Power Apps, and you're starting to type something, it's going to give you suggestions. And instead of competing with the full listing of keywords within Power Apps and functions and everything, I just want to get right at my data sources, my SharePoint list, and I just want to type in TBL and see a list of them.
Wild.
So that's why I'm going to prefix them all with TBL here. And I'm going to say TBL users, and I'm not going to show this in the site navigation. I'm going to click create. We just have a few fields to create here. So we're going to use title for the display name, and we're just going to leave it as is. And I'm going to add in a single line of text for the first name. Now, what you'll notice here is I don't put spaces in the SharePoint list name, and I don't put spaces in the column names either. By leaving out spaces and weird characters out of column names and list names, you get away from having to put names inside a single quotes. All right, so we'll put in here last name. We'll add one and we'll type in here pin. It'll be used as a password or pin. We also want to know is office admin. And I'm going to leave this as a single line of text. I'm not going to make it a Boolean because if I default to this false, I don't know if it's been answered yet. So if it is set as false, I don't know if they've been set as false or it's just the record's never been touched before. So I like to leave this as a single line of text. If it's a true value, I put a capital Y. If it's anything but the capital Y, I know that it's false or it hasn't been set. Right. Technician. Again, single line of text. And this little thing that pops up is very annoying. All right, this technician. There we go. And then we say is active. There we go. One more column that should be in here. I would say is notes. And instead of it being a single line of text, I'd like to make that a multiple line of text. So we'll say notes. Very good. So now I go back to site contents and you see that we have a TBL users. All right, very good. So now what we'll do is we'll go over to our Power Apps. We'll go into the data sources and we're going to add that new list. And you see here we got SharePoint, and we're going to connect to that. There it is, there's Power Apps data, and we're going to pull in TBL users. Very good, all right, so we now have our data source for our users. So I'm going to go find a blank screen here in my project. I've called it blank screen, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this screen. There we go. And we're going to call this manage users screen. Very good. And if we run it, make sure the menu works properly there. Very good. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to copy controls from here and grab some things that I know that I'll need. So typically I will need this light color. So these are just rectangles. So these rectangles, if you look at the color, they just reference my variables that hold a color value. So it's all dynamic. So I'm going to grab that. I'm going to grab some text. I'm going to grab a text box, a drop-down list, and one or two buttons, and also a gallery. So these are all controls I'll know that I'll need. I'll also grab a toggle control. Hit control. I'll go over to my manage user screen. I'll paste it there. Very good. Now, because this was in a group, it grabbed them all. So that's fine. What I'm going to do is grab this one and move it. I'm going to ungroup all of those. Delete those. All right, move this over. I will move the rectangle to the very back. There we go. Move this over here. All right. All right, I'm going to go back over to copy controls from here. I'm going to grab this nice dark color rectangle. I'm going to copy that one. And I'm going to use that label as the header for this gallery. Something else I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the name of this gallery, and I'm going to use the name of the gallery to dynamically set the width of the header rectangle. So I'm going to paste in that name and I'll say dot width. So that will always have the same width as the gallery. So if I increase that, it's going to grow or shrink with it. Okay. Also, if I move the gallery, I want it, the header to move along with it. So I will click on the X. Gallery.x, very good. And we have a border around the gallery, which is 2. So let's set up the border to be 2 and make sure that that rectangle header has a border color that's the same as its fill. So we'll say self.fill, very good. All right, so this gallery, we want to be bound to our new TBL users. There we go. There's no records in it, so nothing's going to show up. We have a label inside in that gallery that references menu label, which we don't want. Let's reference the title. Every SharePoint list will have a title, right? All right, so let's add over a label that will sit inside of this header. And let's make it white. And maybe 17. There we go. We'll put the left padding to be 15. And we will say, right now, display name. We got a little, there we go. So I also want this label to follow this rectangle around, so I'm going to grab the name of that rectangle, then I'm going to go into that label and set up the X. There you go. And also set up the Y. Very good. All right, so the first thing that we need to allow the editing for is that display name. I'll actually set that to be, say, display name. All right, so we have display name there. So instead of it saying text input, let's just take that out for now. And what we want it to display is whatever's selected over here. So that's the gallery name. In fact, we can actually name that gallery gallery users, user list. Make sure I got my casing right. So I'll grab that name, and inside this text box, we're going to say the default is going to be the selected from that gallery, and we will say title. There you go. And now we can just go ahead and create a copy of that, do a Control-C, Control-V, And here we'll make this first name. Very good. Let's make this a little bigger. There you go. Control C, Control V. That over a little bit, and then we will say last name. Then we've got display name. We also have email, so let's do a Control C, Control V for that. All right, email address. All right, so for the default here, instead of the title, this should reference the first name. Very good. This should be last name. All right, so that's already set to title, right? And then we've got email address here. Did we create email address? Let's go back over to our SharePoint list here and we'll find out. So TBL users, we've got settings. And I don't believe we created something for an email address. So let's go ahead and create a new column here. And we'll call email. Click OK. So it's added. Now that we've added something to this TBL users, we've changed it. Power Apps isn't aware of it, so we're going to have to go back into the data sources and do a refresh. Here we go. So now there is no error there. Very good. So we've got display name, first, last name, email. Now we need a pin. So we need another text box and label here. And we'll say, just call this PIN, all uppercase. And for this text box, because this is an admin screen, I'm going to go ahead and I'm thinking of setting this up to be a password. Yeah, I'll set it up to be a password. So if somebody types in this, see that? Now they can click on that. At least you would think, right? You could click on that little icon. It would actually show you what's in there. That's interesting. So maybe that's a browser feature that isn't quite working right. Let's have this little toggle here actually say show pin. Okay, so let's go in here and say show label. We don't want to use that little label off to the side. I rarely like to use that, so what I might do over in this other screen, copy controls from here, and this is an issue that we're going to have with this saving a password. Since if we're using a password field, the browser is always going to want to save it for us. So I'm going to click on that X. All right, I'm going to set this up so if I ever copy it from here again, it's not going to show that. I rarely, if ever, use that, so let's go find show label, set that to false. Very good, hit Control S to save. All right, so we are gonna go back to manage user screen. There it is. Now I need another label here. Okay. There we go. And I am going to right align this label. And we will say show pen. Let's move that over a little bit. Make it look as pretty as we can here. Now, if I were to click on that toggle, it is showing red. That's good. Styled correctly here. So let's actually name this toggle TOG show pen. Okay, all right, so over here on this text box, we'll go look at this mode here. We'll open that up. See how it says text mode, so it's an enumerated value here. So we'll say if that toggle show pin dot value. If that has been toggled on to true, what we're going to do is we'll say text mode dot single line. Otherwise, it'll be not multi-line, it'll be password. And then I like to click format text. There we go. So you see that, how that works? That's sort of neat, huh? All right. So we have display name, first, last name, email, pin. And now let's move stuff down here. Now, I believe we did add notes. I think we've got all the fields that we need here. So these two buttons down here, one will be save. Save record, and this one will be add new. Okay, and I want these buttons to line up a little better with those text boxes. There we go, at least on the right side. Okay, let's take this label and text box and copy and paste it, and we will move it down. This will be notes. And make sure that text box is set up with multi-line for the mode. Okay. Now we're running a little bit out of space, so I'm gonna move things around a little bit here to make more room for everything. So I'm gonna select all these controls. And actually, I want this rectangle to line up with that gallery. Very particular in that everything should line up really nice. So move these up a little bit. So that should look good there. I'm going to take these and I'm going to move them all the way to the top there. And then I'm going to use the down arrow at least once. There you go. See how we do this. You can really conserve space. Well, that label needs to line up, and sometimes you just need to zoom in and make sure that label fits in there really well there. Okay, so get all four of these things and we'll bring that pin label all the way up there, and then we'll use the down arrow. There we go. Now we've got a lot more room to put those other toggles in. So let's copy and paste that. So we have got is office admin, is technician, and is active. So we have three to add in. Okay. So I'm going to line this up with the one above it. So this first one will be is active. Very good. And I'm going to name that toggle is active. I'm going to say never, so hopefully it doesn't ask that anymore. Okay, let's go through and make sure all these text boxes are named properly. So we got TXT, first name. TXT, display name. TXT, last name. TXT, email. And we have TXT pen. Pretty good. All right, so now we're going to copy and paste the toggle here. And I'm going to line it up more on the right side here. There you go. Now this one is going to be is technician. And then we're going to copy that, paste it down below. And let's zoom in here And make sure this is all lining up. Very good. And for this one, it will be Office Admin. TOG for toggle is Technician. G is Office Admin. Very good. And then for the notes, we've got TXT notes. Now, what I'm hoping I can do is move this up a little more. So I've got more room to type in some notes. Zoom out and make this text box a little bigger. There we go. Okay, so it's looking a little nice now. Very good. All right, so we don't have any records. So let's use a patch function. We use a patch function to either update a record or to insert a new. Well, there's no records to edit, so let's just write a patch function that does the new. Okay, so I'm going here to the save button. Now, if you have any spinner controls, let me show you an example of a spinner control. If we go to control copies from here, I'm going to run this. And run this. So spinner control is some type of an animation that lets your user know that the system isn't frozen, is actually working. So if you set the variable that I have set up in this case, it is this variable right here called var show spinner. You set it true, it's gonna make the spinner appear. You set it false, it's gonna make it disappear. So in between these two variables here, I'm gonna use the patch function. There we go. So the patch function receives two arguments, or you're supposed to throw three arguments into it. Okay, so the very first thing here, we'll say TBL, and there's our TBL users right away. Very good. The second parameter you pass in the patch, if you want to add a new record, is use another function called defaults. Very good. Then the third parameter are all the fields, the name of fields and the values that correspond with those names. So we need a curly brace, which signifies a record within Power Apps. So the first thing we want to set is that title. So we've got a TXT display name, and we'll give it the text field. The next thing we have is first name. There we go. Let's say first name. There we go. Dot text. Last name. And as you see, as I'm typing, you see some items there that pop up down below the code window that gives me suggestions. So I'll back up and do that again. As I type in last name, you see it says last name there at the bottom. As I'm typing, if the very first item is the one that I want, I just hit tab and it types it in there for me. So TXT, last name, which I do the same thing for the control names. That's what's great about having them all named, that text. All right, so we've got that, the last name. Let's look at email. Here's an TXT, email.text. Very good. And let's look at the pin. There it is, TXT pin.text. Okay. So what I'm thinking for, so I'm moving on, just look at the show pin. I want to make sure the default is set to false, because whenever they come here, I don't want it to be displaying passwords. So I just wanted to make sure that was off, and it is, so that's fine. So we'll get the pin, and we'll say is, actually is active was the next one. All right, so for Boolean fields, a Boolean field is a yes, no, true, false type of field. Now, what I do is I create the single line of text in the SharePoint list, and I don't create it as a Boolean in the back end in the database, because I want to know if something has specifically been put in there rather than, I don't know, it's false. Is it because it hasn't been initialized yet? So that's why I use that. So for this is active, instead of just saying toggle is active dot value, what we want to do is we say if it's been toggled on, then we're going to pass in a capital Y. If not, we're going to give it a capital N for no. Okay, so maybe quite different than most people. I think most people go in there and like, oh, I need a Boolean, a yes, no, a checkbox, that type of thing. So I actually created in the database is that. And I've just sort of learned not to do that. It's based on experience. So hopefully that makes sense. So we got is active. We have, I think we just have three. Yeah, is technician. Is technician. So if, you know what we can do is we'll just go up to the line above and we'll just copy that line right there. Take out that comma for right now. And we'll say tog is technician. There we go. All right, now we're going to copy that one, put that comma in there, and then paste. And this one will be is office admin tog is office admin. There we go. Now we also do have notes. Notes, txt notes, text. I think that is everything. First, last name, display name, email, PIN, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we should have 9 total, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we do, very good. All right, so let's try this out. We'll see how it goes. Darren, niece. Darren, developer. Email address, let's put that in as Darren, niece, that us. All right, the PIN. Let's type in 0123. How about that? So we'll show the PIN. Oh, there it is. Okay, very good. I want to be active. I want to be able to do everything a technician can do, and I also want to be able to do everything an office admin can do. Darren is the developer application. I'm going to hit save. Cross your fingers. There we go. Hey, look at that. We have a record. All right. So something that I noticed is my spinner isn't appearing on top. So the first thing is I'll make sure the menu is always on top first. I'll go down and find my spinner, anything that might, like a group here. So we've got an image and a rectangle. I'll move that up to the very top. There we go. All right. So now that we've done all that, I'm going to hit save, Control S. And we'll go over to SharePoint and make sure that record has been saved over there and all the data points are over there that we expect to be over there. All right, so let's go back. Let's go over to SharePoint and see that the data is here. So we have Darren developer, Darren niece. There's the PIN. He's an office admin. He's a technician. He's active. There's the notes and there is the email address. Very good. Looks good to me. Let's enter a few more. Okay. So what you notice here is that, okay, I'm ready to add in another record full of values. The values are there, sitting there. And I don't want them to sit there. I want everything to be reset. Now, we're not dealing with a form here. We're not going to say new form and everything's going to magically be reset. So what I'm going to do here is there's a little button here called Add New, and it's there on purpose, of course. So we'll go into the action for that button, and we'll clear this out. And we're gonna create a context variable. And to create one, we're going to use update context, use some curly braces, of course, that we need in there. And we'll create a little context variable called New Record. And here we actually will use a Boolean variable, New Record. Okay, so we'll save that code right there, and we'll go over to the save button. So let's say this is a new record. They've entered new values, and after it's done saving, We're going to set that variable to be false because it's no longer a new record. It's going to be an existing record at that point, right? So for each of these controls here, we want to go into default and we will set something up here. And we'll say if new record, we want the default value to be an empty string. Otherwise, we'll bring in the currently selected value there. Okay. Very good. So we will use this code right here on most of these other controls. So I'm going to copy that portion. I'm going to go over to the default for this last name, put in an ending parenthesis, and we'll do that for each of these controls. Okay, look at this, this pen. I don't want the email in there. We actually want the pen in there. Okay, there we go. All right, is active. So the default here is just straight up set to false. So I'm gonna take this whole value here and go into that is active for the default. I'm gonna paste. And if, you know, if I'm going to add a brand new user into this system, chances are I want them to be active. So I'm going to set this thing to be true by default. Now, most of the time I would set things to be false for a toggle or a Boolean. But in this case, a new user, I want to be active. Okay, so is active equals capital Y. There we go. Now I am going to copy this because all these other two toggles are going to have something very similar, except instead of defaulting them to true, I want them to be false for both of them. I want them to specifically enable them as a technician and or office admin. As technician. Okay. False is office admin. There we go. Now let's select this thing here. We'll go down to the notes for default for the notes. And we will say notes. Very good. Okay. All right. So hopefully what's going to happen here, I want to run. I'm going to hit this add new. And it's blinked everything out and sort of initialized everything for me. Okay. So I'm going to put in a name of John Doe, Johnny Doe. That's his display name. All right, so john@doe.com. His pin is also going to be 0123. Let's show it, make sure that's actually set up right. It is. Very good. He is active, and I'm just going to make him a technician. Say Johnny is a great tech. I'm going to save that record. Look at that. We got Johnny Doe. So if I click on Johnny Doe, it's going to display John's information. If I click on Darren, Darren's information is going to show up. Okay. Now let's add a new record for an office admin. Let's make a Mary Smith. Now, do you notice what I did there when I typed in Mary? I put in a space. Now users are going to do this all the time. Do you want that space in there in the database? Probably not. So let's, while we have that on our mind, let's click on that save button. We'll go in and we'll use a function on this first name and we'll say trim. For each of these text fields, I would want that in there. Trim. Now, I'm not going to do that for pen, and I'm not going to do that for notes. If they tie up a space in one of those two fields, I'm going to capture it, and that's how it's going to be. All right. Something else I meant to do is for this display name, is if whatever I get here is a blank, let's say the display name, by default, you want it to be the first and last name. Instead of it being an empty string there, we're going to say txt first name. Yeah, well, we would only do this for a new record if they've already set it. Now, if they set up a display name as blank for an existing record, hopefully they wouldn't do something like that. Text. And we'll splice some string, splice in an empty, a space in there, a string literal. So txt last name. Dot text. There we go. So we have a default value in there. So you're adding a new record. It's going to throw that in there. Now, because I added that space in there, you see that? It's got two spaces in there. So I'm going to put a trim around these two things, and it should look better. Very good. All right, so mary@smith.com, and her pen is gonna be 0123. She's gonna be active, and I'm gonna make her an office admin. And notes, Mary is great at talking with the customers. And we'll leave it at that. I'm going to click save. Very good. There's Mary. All right. So we have a developer here who's a technician and an office admin. We got the Johnny, who's a technician, and Mary, who is an office admin. So we have those three users. Now, every time we hit save, it will be adding a new record. So we don't want that at this point. Now that we have records to edit, and we didn't click on that add new, what we want to do is set this up in the button, and we're going to check on that variable. So remember how we got that little variable new record? So if it's a new record, we're going to do this patch right here. If it's not a new record, what we're going to do is we're going to do another patch, very similar to the previous one. Okay, but we don't want that comma there. Instead of giving it the defaults, which gives us a new record, we're actually going to use lookup to go find the record. So lookup, TBL users. And what we're going to say here is ID. So every SharePoint list has a field in there called ID. You didn't have to create it. It's an identity field, which means that if you create a new record, there's no records in there. You create the first record, it's going to have an ID of 1. The second one's going to have 2. And the third one's going to have 3. Now you delete 2, 2's out of there. And then the next one that's created would be 4. So we're going to say where ID equals the gallery. What was our gallery name? Let's go look for that gallery. Gallery user list, that sounds right. So we'll say dot selected dot ID. So what that's gonna do, that lookup is gonna go get that record, the one that we're trying to edit, and return it into that, and actually pass it in that patch function. All right, here's all the fields that we're gonna pass in to update. That's good. And that should be it. So for this Darren developer, let's put in here Darren Neese, and inside the parentheses, I just want the uppercase dev. I'm gonna hit save, and it took it. Very good. So this is looking good. I'm gonna exit out here. I'm gonna hit Control S. Once I get something done, I always like to hit save, save often, save early, save often. Here we go. So now we have all of our users. All right, you know what I realized? I realized that I like photos of people. If I have records that represent people, I like to have a photo of them. So as I was clicking around, I'm like, what's missing here? It's we need photos of people. So I've actually created a whole video that focuses on doing just what we're about to do. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time explaining, but just know that there is a video where I take time, and it was a 16-minute video where I walk through all the steps. I mean, we're going to do them here, but if you want to take more time and perhaps understand it more thoroughly, I talk about it in that video. Just wanted to mention that before we do that. So I'm going to go over here to my requirements document and actually add that as a field here. So I'm going to put in here photo, just so my requirements document is complete and it's accurate to what the application is actually going to do. All right. So the first thing I want to do is go over to our list here, and we're going to go over to the very end. And we're going to add in multiple lines of text. Now, the photo is going to be stored, and I go over this in the video, why we use the multiple lines of text. Photo, multiple lines of text, that's good. I'm going to click save. And the reason why that I explained in the video is if you add it in as an attachment, say we say new, and we go over to attachments and upload the photo as attachment. What's weird about SharePoint is sometimes, a lot of times, it doesn't show the photos. It doesn't go get that data. So a way to sort of get around that is to actually store it into a text field. So that's what we're going to do. All right. Now that we've added that new field within Power Apps, we actually need to refresh the data source so that it knows that it's there. All right. Now we're going to need to make some room for this. I think what I'd like to do is put all these toggles together, perhaps. So I can select all these controls here, and I'll say align to the top, select all these, and align these to the top. And I think I'd like to move it over. I'm gonna use my arrow keys to move it over a little bit. And select all of them and move them over a little more, as much as I can, without it looking weird. Okay, there we go. So we have a little bit of room to deal with an image. So I'm gonna go to the top, insert. We're gonna go over to media. And let's add an add picture set of controls. It's actually two controls grouped together. And it needs to be much smaller. Okay, so we'll do that. And so this control here, it's got a really large font size for some reason. Let's make that like 12. Maybe 10. Now for the back color for this guy, which is the fill, let's go over here and type in fill. And it's a white color. Let's set this up to have a 50% transparency. Okay. That's not too bad. Maybe 70%. Because it's a little too light. Okay. And what I'd like for this to be is a nice square. So let's go with 150 by 100, 150. But the other one needs to be set up. See, there's two controls within this group. So this needs to be 150. All right, very good. So move that up here. I found a great website for something like this. And let me bring it down here. It's called thispersondoesnotexist.com. So whenever you go in here and let's say hit refresh, it's going to give you another person that doesn't exist. I believe these photos are generated with AI. So I can just go in here, save image as, and we could just save them in the same directory here. Well, I know that we need a photo of a male. Does that look like Johnny? That looks like Johnny. Let's use Johnny here. Put him in there. We'll call him Johnny. Okay. And we'll open up this folder here that I saved him in. So now we have the photos saved on the hard drive. So what we need to do is we need to set this image here. So it already has code in here and it checks to see if something is blank. If it's blank, it's going to add in a sample image. Otherwise, it's going to use the add media button 1.media. I think in this case, what we're going to do, instead of using that sample image, we actually need to look at that variable that we had before. If new record, we'll use that sample image. Okay. Otherwise, we'll use gallery user list.selected dot photo. There we go. We'll just throw that in there. How about that? Now, in this case, there's no photos for any of these people. So what we could do is if there is, we'll do another if. Let's open this up. This code is going to get a little hairy here. So we'll say, for this photo here, if the length of that equals 0, which means if it hasn't been set yet, we'll go ahead and use a sample image. And by the way, sample image is a predefined image in the Power Apps environment for like a default sample image. If you don't have an image for anything, you could use that. And I think you saw that image a few moments ago before we started writing this code. All right, so we'll use a sample image. If there is a value, then we'll go ahead and use it. There we go. And I think this is all good. And we will see here soon. So we're gonna grab the name of that image control, uploaded image 1, because inside the save button, I'll put a comment here. I'm gonna say photo equals that image. There we go. Now, something I explained in the video that I've already done about saving images in SharePoint is that we have some code. I know it's a substitute. There we go, substitute. And a substitute takes a string and then it looks for a string. So in this case, it's looking for double quotes and it's gonna replace it with an empty string. Now, this image, we need to wrap this with a JSON function. And inside of it, this JSON function, we need to give it a parameter of, it's like include binary data. Yeah. And I think that's it. I think that's what is needed to save that as a string. Otherwise, it's not going to be like, what is this? This isn't a string, but if you use JSON, it serializes that binary data into text, which is exactly what we need here. So I'm hoping this works. I'm going to hit run, hit Darren. I'm going to click on this tab or click. All right, so we'll go into the files here, and I'll select myself. There we go. All right, cross your fingers. Save. Ah, it's on top of my spinner. All right, so I need to right-click on my menu, make sure that's on top, and click on my spinner, make sure that's on top. Very good. Let's open this gallery up a little more. So the template size is 50, so the row's height is 50. Let's make that 120. It's probably a little too much. Let's go with 100. Okay, I'm going to click on that label inside there. I'm going to move it over a little bit. And I'm going to go find myself an image up here at the top. Very good. And what I like to do with images is we do have some padding that we can use. I like to put some padding in there of 4 pixels all the way around. And I like to give the background color to be white. There we go. How's that look? Not bad. All right. So for this image, see where it says image here for sample? So that's the sample image right there. We don't want the sample image. What we want is this item, dot photo. Hey, look at that. It worked. All right, very good. I shouldn't be surprised that it worked. All right, so let's move this guy over. There we go. What I don't like is, see that photo right there just sticking around, sitting around like that? Yeah, I don't like that. So what is going on here? So we're not, if the user clicks on an item here in this gallery, we don't want that new record to be set. So I just want to make sure that that's something that we should have. So we click on this save button, we have it resets that new record to false. So anytime somebody clicks, let's say they click on add new, but they select someone else, so they change their mind. So we actually want to set this up so it sets that as false, okay? So let me run that, make sure that's not the issue. It's not the issue, but that needed to be in there anyway. Something else you need to do for this image, I'm not sure if we did this. Yeah, the select parent should be in there, so they can select a row by clicking on the image. That's good. So let's go back to this image here, and let's look at this, because I want that to be reset. And, oh, I see what's going on. You see where it says is blank? And it's not blank. So what I think that we should do, copy that. Now what I'm going to do, I'm not going to delete the, I'm going to change, I'm going to comment this out just in case my thinking is not right. We don't want that. I think that should probably take care of everything there. Okay. There we go. Yeah. So I had some code in there that, that was inserted in there when we brought the control over, and it really didn't serve our situation just right. So we modified it. We took some of that out. All right. So Johnny Doe, John Doe, there is his photo. And it's not displaying him. Okay. So let's figure this one out here. Okay. See, it's good that I didn't delete that, because I think we actually do need that. Okay. This thing right here, I think we should reset it on the click event over here. So there's a function called reset. There we go. I'm hoping that works. All right, I'm going to save the Johnny record because we've got that photo there. There we go. If I click over to Darren, there's that. There we go. All right, so Mary. Here's Mary. We'll save Mary's record. There we go. All right, we're looking good now. All right. So if you're looking at a list of users here, there's two types of users. There's office admin and there are technicians. So wouldn't you want to know which is which instead of having to click on one first and then looking? I would. So what I'd like to do here is let's put something over here that will tell us if they're a technician. Now, a lot of times people will probably use icons here. I don't think icons would be good because you've got, I mean, what icon are you going to put over there that would say technician? You know, you probably pick an icon that looks like a person, you know? So if we were to go over here and insert an icon, I just add the very first one, add one. There you go. And then I go over here to this icon drop down to go look for an icon. So I said person, So a technician's a person, but an office admin's a person too. So you're going to have two of the same icon. That doesn't really work out very well. So in a case like this, either go out to a website that has a lot more icons to choose from, some little images that I can pop in here that would better signify those functions or those roles. But I think what's going to work out best here, or in situations like this, if we add a little label, but we make it look really cool. And how we do that is, so this first one, this is going to be for technicians. So for the text, we're not going to dynamically assign a field value from the record. We're actually going to say technician. And we're going to make it really small, like 8 point. We're going to center it. We're going to give it a back color, like a nice blue color. And then we're going to make the font color to be white. See that? There we go. And we just make it a little cute little tag in there, okay? So let's go look at this thing here. It's looking good, all right. Showing you guys all my secrets here. All right, so to make this cuter, I'm gonna go to the border. I'm gonna set the border to be solid one. Now for the border color, I want to write some code in here for border color. And what we're going to say is we're going to go look at the fill, self.fill. There we go. And I'm going to say color fade. Now I'm not actually going to fade it. I'm going to use a negative number to make it darker. So 35% darker, perhaps. Look at that. That's what looks cool, doesn't it? All right. So also, I don't know, you might want to pick a different a font that looks better, Arial, Lato, ooh, I don't know about that. Verdana, no. Or you can just keep it the way it was. I think Open Sans was what we had before, that's fine. And I was thinking about making it bold, but I think I'll just leave it as is, okay? All right, so I'm gonna make a copy, do a copy and paste, and then we will make this one office admin. There we go. Now it's a little too narrow, so let's make this more like 100. There we go. So if it's both of them, there we go. We'll center it on the line, but you always got to realize a gallery, once you get a few rows in here, you're going to have a little scroll bar. So we want to move it away from the left side of that gallery. Click on Office Admin, and we are going to go in here and give it a nice green color. Look at that. I like that. All right, so for the technician, we're going to hide this label if they're not a technician. So click on Visible. Okay, and we'll say this item dot is technician. Now remember, this really isn't a Boolean yes, no field. So I have to say, if it's a technician, if that field actually has a Y in there, it'll be displayed. Now I'm going to copy that whole thing, go over to Office Admin, go into Visible. We'll say, is Office Admin. There we go. Then I'm going to hit Control S to save it. I'm going to run it. Look at that. So you see, Darren, he's a technician and an office admin. Johnny is just a technician. Mary's just an office admin. And everything's good. Look at that. All right. A few other things I'll change about this. So the display name, what I'm going to do here, because, I mean, I initially was thinking this would be just a column header, but we've got the photo in there. And instead of having just a list of columns going across a gallery, I think what I'll do here is I'll make this span the whole way across. I'll center it, and I'll just say users. So these are all the users in the system, okay? All right. Now, let's just look at this screen here and see anything else we need to tweak. Now, I see a little drop-down list. I thought I might Need that. I don't need it for anything, so I'm going to take that out. All right. All right, very good. Now this little rectangle here, what I like to do is set this border over here. Let's make that 2. And for the border color, we'll use the fill. So we'll say self.fill. And we're going to do what we did before, which is we'll do a color fade with a negative number. Negative 35%, and we'll see how that looks. I sort of like it. All right. I think this screen might be done. Okay. So I think I'm going to move on to, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the home screen and actually have these users display on the home screen. So I'm going to go ahead and save. Very good. Let's do that. All right. So 3 users is not a lot. So let's add a few more in here. Let's add in a Randy. You know, I did find a fake name generator website. So homepage.net/name_generator. So go here and you type in how many names you want. It also gives you an email address as well. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to use those. All right, so we have Randy. Let's just pick a last name here. KRR, very good. Email address. Let's just say rkerr@domain.com. And I'm going to set everybody's pin to be 0123. Just so we can test, we can log on as different users and test things, and we don't have to remember people's passwords. So when we deploy this, we can delete out the test users and actually add real users in. Okay, but it's good to have some test data. All right, so I'm going to go find a, that looks like a Randy. All right, Randy. There we go. There's Randy. Let's make Randy a technician, and we'll say Randy is great. Save him. Very good. There we go. There's Randy. Let's add a new user, and here we go. Let us. There's an Abigail. Well, it's got a lot of spaces in there, but we got the trim in there, so it's going to handle all those spaces, right? Her last name is going to be Johnston. There we go. And we'll say johnston@domain.com. Her pin will be 0123. We're going to save Abigail. Very good. There's Abigail. We'll save that record. You know what? We didn't, we have her set up as a technician. Actually, we didn't set her up as either type of user. Let's set her up as a technician. That's fine. And let's go find another person. There we go. And this person will be Dorothy. Dorothy Sutherland. Her email address will be sutherland@domain.com. 0123. Dorothy, there we go. Office admin, there we go. And you know what? Let's add another technician. There we go. And this will, his name will be Thomas. Let me click save just to make sure that's saved. And we'll hit new. So we have Thomas, Avery, and we'll say tom@domain.com. 0123. So this is good. As you enter some test data, you start coming across any bugs or anything, any weird logic. So we have this information. Thomas is going to be a technician. All right, so one thing I did realize I need to do, if you recall, when we clicked on the gallery here, we update the context to make sure that new record's false, and then we reset that add media button, right? So over on the add new button, we should do the same thing. Okay, so if we're going to add a new record, click on add new, and it's going to reset that. I think that's what sort of messed me up a few moments ago, when I was entering a new record. So the previous record's photo was still in there, so that's what messed me up. All right, so now that that's out in there, we should be good. That bug that I thought, which actually was there, is now fixed, hopefully. So we'll move on to the home screen / login page now. I'm pretty happy with what I see here and how it all works. So the next part will be the home screen, or should we say the login screen, because we're not going to have an Office 365 user log in and out. They're going to be already logged into the kiosk, so they're going to walk up to the home screen. They're going to click on their picture, their name, type in a password, and then we'll know it's that person because they knew the password and they clicked on themselves. This is the screen that an Office admin would use to enter new users. So this home screen will be the login screen. They'll see the list of users. What I imagine is the technicians will be on the left. Office admin will be on the right. They know either they're one or the other. They select themselves. They type in the password. They hit login. Gets them in. It takes them to the whatever screen they should go to at that point. And so let's work on this screen.
If you found anything in this video helpful, we would really appreciate you click on that like button. If you want to get a solid foundation on Power Apps, there are 10 things you must know. Lucky for you, my husband wrote the book. We are actually offering it for free. Click on the link below to download your free copy today. And if you want to connect with us or work with Darren directly, visit our website. The link is below. Thanks.